elevated hunting stands are something that, you know, they're an integral part of hunting. They really allow you to do a lot of different things and set yourself up in scenarios to give you an advantage. When you look at the different lock-on stands and ladder stands and the two-person ladder stands and the climbing stands and the modifications that have been made to all those stands, it allows a hunter to be able to pretty much find a way to get elevated in about every hunting situation that there is. First and foremost for me, once we find a place to be elevated, I immediately start thinking about safety. But you've got to be safe in these tree stands. I remember reading a lot of stats years ago about people falling out and the injuries that they had in tree stands. And one thing I will say, the modern stands are a lot better. People are a lot more aware of it, and there's a lot more assets out there to make it safer for you to be elevated. But you've got to make sure and put the effort into securing everything from the steps to the stands, to the ladders, and I mean, I'm probably a little bit anal when it comes to that, but I really want to make sure that safety is a paramount aspect of setting up a deer stand when we're going to be elevated. After we get everything nice and secure, the next thing for me is, how is this stand going to hunt? Where do we need to cut shooting lanes? Shooting lanes are always going to be a factor, especially if you're hunting with a bow or even a handgun or crossbow. You want to make sure you've got shooting lanes. And what I try to do in those situations is, I climb up in a stand, I'm visualizing where I think the deer are going to come from. Hopefully we've already got a little data from scouting cameras, past experience in the area, you know, feedback from other hunters, whatever it may be, and then obviously deer sign, to know that deer are going to come left or right in this situation. Here's our favorable or our, you know, most consistent winds in there, and then we can start to pick what brush we want to clear. You never want to cut all the brush down, because that's going to allow you to get skylighted or picked off when the deer see you. They're going to see your movement, so you want to cut just enough to make sure you've got shooting lanes, but not too much that you're going to be exposed. From there, after you get everything set up in those situations, accessorize. You know, some people just are going to sit there with their bow or whatever they're hunting with right in their lap. For me, I like to have everything set up within hand's length of me, so I'm not getting fatigue. I don't want to hold my bow all the time. I believe that, you know, gets your hands tired, you start sweating in those situations. Has it burned me by not holding it all the time? Absolutely at times, but I feel like also by being more relaxed and not tense and holding onto it, worried about the bow falling out onto the ground, I feel like I'm not as tense. So it's a personal preference. I'm gonna use a bow hanger to hang things, my range finders if I need one for a rifle hunt or a handgun hunt. My bow will be sitting there. Binoculars, I mean, I'm a big believer in using optics in any type of situation. It also provides a lot of time another place to hang your scent coverage type devices or whatever you need to. You know, so many people now are using point of view cameras. It's another place to hang a point of view camera. So those accessories, once you get up there, are really going to be key. And then finally, being comfortable. There's nothing worse than being in a stand and you lose the feeling in your feet after about 1 minute, and because then you're moving. And when you're moving, you're making sound, and you're, you know, there's unnatural things going on in the environment, which allows those deer to pick you off. And I think the modern stands that we use today, you know, stands by companies like Hawk, stands by companies like Muddy, and there's others out there, they're designed to allow you to be comfortable, safe, secure, and when that moment of truth comes, put yourself in a position to get the shot. In closing, when it comes to elevated stands, find the one that fits your situation. When you get online at places like Hawk and Muddy Outdoors, they've got a lot of different stands that's going to allow you to pick what's going to work for where you're hunting. And when you put those stands in the right situations, accessorize them, get the shooting lanes set up for you, and you make everything safe and secure, you're going to have a comfortable hunt. And I think all of those together increase your odds of success when you get a deer out in front of you.